welcome to the recap of today's CodeBuddies.org live code hangout. Today we've been working on the sustainable urban design project. We're working primarily in Python today. We do have a JavaScript client, but right now we're working with the model on a feature called projects. Essentially what projects are is large-scale urban design and development initiatives that have multiple collaborators and geographic scope. You know, it could be like there's something like putting in a urban transport network or a tram line like we have here in Tampere, or they could be really small district revitalizations, anything that app isn't really too specific. It's just needs to let people collaborate, really. So we've already defined a model for projects in general, and they're also hierarchical. Projects can actually not at this point, they're not hierarchical, but the idea is that projects can have sub projects and people can be associated with those projects. But right now all we're focusing on is adding a geographic scope, and we'll come back to the collaboration and the hierarchy and other subsequent work. So I created a pull request today. It was pretty straightforward. We're just using kind of off-the-shelf stuff. Django's got some built-in geospatial libraries that are built on the rich Python ecosystem. And Wagtail makes it pretty easy to also add new fields and render the correct widgets in the Wagtail editing interface. So it was really smooth sailing today. So let's just take a quick look at the change. So what we have, our project, we have the Wagtail admin has an area where we list projects here, and for each project you can edit it with a title and a description and a geographic area. And this field is it lets you kind of edit the geometry. It's actually a geography. It's a little bit different because it's using latitude and longitude coordinates. So you could get a really precise shape for the city of Tampere. I'll have to figure out how to allow people to upload maybe GeoJSON or shapefiles, but for now I'm just happy to have something working. And what that's going to let us do is use this as a query, a constraint for the to query only what are called points of interest in a given in this spatial extent. Likewise, on the Django administration UI, which is not meant for kind of end users. Wagtail is designed specifically for kind of end users who are in special editing, have editing privileges, generally speaking. This is primarily for administrators, but in any case, I've got them both running, and oops, I haven't saved this. So yeah, let's go ahead. Here's the old geometry, and if I save this now, and I reload this, we should see the change there as well. So, you know, two views of the same thing. We just configured them in both places and used a OpenStreetMap widget, which by default, it actually uses, here I'll just show you the Wagtail default viewer. They both use the NASA World View base map, which is, I think, really beautiful. It's just, you know, just showing the Earth, no other sort of labels or city boundaries or anything like that. We just see we're, you know, just surrounded by and, you know, part of nature. Which is something I think we lose touch with in our urban lives and busy going, you know, day to day, to work and home and hobbies and things like that. And when we look at maps like the OpenStreetMap or Google Maps, you know, we forget that there's nature there. All we see are these labels, and you know, we see some natural forms, but really, mostly what we're concerned with are streets and buildings and stuff like that. So in any case. We're going to have to use this base map more or less because people are trying to work in cities and improve them. So we want to show some of the geographic features. Okay, so let's just take a quick look at the code. A little bit of an aside there, but yeah. You can see just in this demo though how quick it is and easy for me to toggle those because it's just already prepared. So what we did is just added a field like to our project model, and I called it geographic area. And by default, it uses geometry, which are like coordinates on a flat Cartesian plane, and our geography coordinates are the lat-long, so they're on a spherical or spheroid, spherical body. And you know, just to make it easier for myself, I allowed this field to be null, or just no value provided. I don't know what a sensible default would be for this, but also I don't know how these projects would really work without a geographic scope. I'll have to cross that bridge when it arises. The only other thing we changed here in the project model is to tell Wagtail how to auto-generate, or how to render this in its auto-generated editing form. And essentially, what Wagtail has this idea of a field panel that pretty much just figures out the right type of field based on the field type. Rich text is a special case, but if it's a character field, it'll show rendered in a text widget. If it's a even this special polygon field, it I guess refers to Django and new to render it in a map widget with the I think this is Leaflet.js, yeah. And I just need, then I can define a particular widget in general, or specifically I wanted to use this OpenStreetMap widget. And the only other file we really edited here was just to register the project model with the Django administration. I realized it wasn't in the administration UI. I'm not leaning heavily on the Django administration UI, but in any case, I just wanted to quickly preview the project and to see if things were working. The main thing here is there's a few different types of admin. You have to, this is actually the thing. If you're not careful, when you switch to over to the Django GIS or the GeoDjango stuff, you can make simple mistakes, and I made a few simple mistakes. But here we renamed the main folder to core, and I reorganized our app imports. So one thing you have to do when you're installing GeoDjango is install this Django contrib GIS. And then you also have to configure your data sources, your database engine, to use this, where in our case we're using PostGIS. So those are the two settings I forgot to mention. Then you have to be careful on your imports. So if you notice, everything is referring to models here. The Django GIS DB models basically, I think, extends the default Django models to add a few spatial types. So you just switch your import here from Django, I think, DB, Django, I don't know if it's core. Anyway, I switched the import we can see here in the pull request, come to think of it. A few things, so I just renamed the core folder. Here it is, the apps, and so Django.db models, we just imported Django contrib GIS DB models. So everything basically has a contrib GIS inside of it. And we also wanted that OSM widget here. So that was the thing. It took me a little bit. And I followed the Django admin recipe for registering a model with the Django admin. But again, you have to not just register with a regular Django admin. You have to register with the Django contrib GIS admin. And it even has a specific OSM geoadmin to render the OSM map. But that was just a matter of me reading the docs a little bit more carefully. And frankly, it was fairly easy to figure out. I don't remember if it was the nature of the error messages or if it was intuitive. I can't remember exactly what, but I didn't really struggle. That's the main takeaway. Today's session was fairly smooth. So yep, that's a recap, and we'll continue working on this project feature probably over the weekend. So this has been a Code Buddies live code hangout. If you're interested in getting involved with this or similar projects, stop by codebuddies.org. There's a lot of different hangouts and study groups forming there. Code Buddies platform itself is also open source. You can get involved with the Code Buddies rewrite at github.com/codebuddies. The project URL for the Sustainable Urban Design project is github.com/sustainableurbandesign. Thank you very much for your time, and have a great day.